At dawn on September 6, 2007, Israeli warplanes destroyed an industrial building near al-Kibar, Syria. The building, later revealed to be an under-construction nuclear reactor, was located on the banks of the Euphrates River in Deir ez-Zor, 250 miles northeast of Damascus. While the reactor was nearly finished at the time of the Israeli strike, fuel had not been loaded into the core, and the reactor had not been started. At the time, there was some media speculation that the facility was a covert nuclear reactor, and this suspicion was confirmed by the U.S. intelligence community in April 2008. To this day, the Syrian government insists that the facility was not a reactor. Information provided by the U.S. intelligence community established a pattern of nuclear cooperation between North Korea and Syria, including technology transfers, cargo shipments, and meetings between high-level officials dating back to 1997. Construction of the covert reactor at al-Kibar, located in a remote area of Syria's eastern desert, probably began in 2001. The terrain surrounding the site, as well as building modifications, indicate attempts to conceal the existence and purpose of the structure. The reactor was hidden in a ravine, making it visible only from above. A nondescript pump house would have sent water uphill to an underground reservoir to cool the reactor. To avoid detection, the reactor building's facade was designed to look like one of the Byzantine fortresses that dot the Syrian countryside. Additionally, the site lacked any overt defensive or security features, which could have drawn undue attention. An initial comparison of the al-Kibar reactor building with the 5-megawatt reactor in Yongbyon, North Korea, shows only a passing similarity. However, when the al-Kibar reactor's facade is removed and the underground portion exposed, the resemblance becomes pronounced. The reactor's fuel configurations are also very similar. Both reactors' designs are optimized to produce plutonium, which can later be extracted from their spent fuel rods. Following the Israeli strike, Syria rapidly removed equipment and debris, erasing useful evidence by putting a new layer of topsoil over the site and constructing a metal-framed building on top. Presumably to provide a plausible explanation for the cooling system, the reactor's pump house was connected to a water treatment plant 6 kilometers inland from the river. After the alleged reactor's destruction, the IAEA requested permission to inspect the site. Syria rejected its request, claiming the installation was a non-nuclear military facility, which the IAEA had no right to access. Eventually, under international pressure, Syria allowed a team of IAEA inspectors to visit the site in June 2008. There, inspectors uncovered evidence of undeclared nuclear material and assessed that the containment structure, overall size of the building, and water pumping capacity could be sufficient for a nuclear reactor. The IAEA also sought access to 3 other sites, near Marj al-Sultan, Iskandaria, and Mosayef, which it suspected were related to a covert nuclear program, but Syria denied these requests. On June 9, 2011, the IAEA Board of Governors found Syria in non-compliance with its safeguards agreement and reported it to the United Nations Security Council. The 2011 onset of civil war in Syria has resulted in a number of sites throughout the country falling into rebel control. In February 2013, the al-Kibar site reportedly came under the control of the Syrian Free Army, and video footage allegedly documenting the state of the site became available. According to the video, the new building has been used as a stationary launch site for short-range Scud ballistic missiles.